Adenosine is effective in terminating supraventricular tachycardia. It temporarily blocks conduction through the AV node for about 10 seconds. Now, it's important to note that adenosine does not convert atrial fibrillation, atrial flutter, or other tachycardias caused by mechanisms other than a reentry through the AV node. Some of the indications are as follows. Adenosine is indicated for supraventricular tachycardia, or SVT for short, tachycardia caused by a reentry at the SA node, or as a diagnostic tool to distinguish atrial flutter from SVT. So there's some precautions and contraindications. Remember, adenosine needs to be given rapid IV push, and the most common cause of failure is pushing the drug too slowly. A brief period of 10 to 15 seconds of bradycardia, asystole, or even third degree heart block could follow after administration of adenosine. If the child's old enough to understand, consider warning the child that they may feel a little uncomfortable for a few seconds after giving the medication, but just reassure them that they're in good hands and we're going to take good care of them. The initial dose should be decreased by approximately 75% for patients receiving carbamazepine or dipyridamole, or those with heart transplants. Pediatric dosages for this medication should be delivered IV or IO, rapid push, as quickly as possible. The initial dose is 0.1 milligram per kilogram for a maximum dose of 6 milligrams, followed by a normal saline flush of up to 20 cc's. If the first dose does not convert the rhythm, a second dose of 0.2 milligrams per kilogram for a maximum dose of 12 milligrams could be given. Again, flush that second dose with a normal saline bolus of 20 cc's of normal saline in that syringe, and that'll get that medication into the circulatory system much faster. Make sure that we're recording the ECG rhythm during this full administration and treatment process.